Hello everyone, this is David Liu, and today we're going to talk about my research last summer, which is, as you can see on the slide, about blue crabs and their population's relationship with Hemagglutinin parasy, a type of parasite disease. Well, let's get started then. So what is blue crab? Blue crab is a type of crab that lives along the western edge of Atlantic Ocean and Mexico Bay. And Chesapeake Bay is also one of their main habitats, and it's next to our school, and that is the place where most of our data come from. So in Chesapeake Bay, in 2009, people earned like $79 million just by catching blue crabs. So we can tell that blue crabs contain a lot of economic values. However, the population for blue crabs has been decreased a lot. Why is that? There are multiple factors, one of which is Hemagglutinin parasy, a parasite disease. So now let's take a look at the flowchart of the model. Before introducing the flowchart, let's talk about the background, a little bit background about blue crabs. So blue crabs contain three stages of life: the larvae, the juvenile, and the adult. The larvae is kind of really young crabs, and that doesn't really matter a lot, so we didn't include it in the model. However, the juvenile and the adult crabs will be included in the model a lot. So let's assume that here's a very young, lucky blue crab who didn't get infected throughout its life. Then it would first mature and becoming an adult crab, then it would just reproduce and become like end a life cycle. However, if a crab gets infected, then it would die in a period of time. Well, in this process, the infected crab would constantly release parasites into the free water. Parasite itself can only live for like 3 minutes in the free water, but it will do its best to infect other crabs. And that's how it works. So there are two small details about this process. So juvenile crabs, if they get infected, it's kind of really unlikely for them to mature and become adult crabs. However, for adult infected crabs, it is possible to reproduce and breed young crabs. So that's kind of interesting. And this is like how the flowchart and how the model works. And next, here is some simulation results. So the left diagram is the simulation result of a model without the disease factor, and the right diagram is the model with the disease factor. We can see that the disease really changed a lot of the population. And however, we didn't fully like decided what the parameters for the disease are, so it might be a little bit inaccurate, but this is like the simulation result of our current progress. And that's about it for my research. Thank you so much for watching.